Juneteenth. He's perfect for Juneteenth, you guys. Now stop clapping right now. Give him an E-bomb. Boom! I can run up to the line. Choose the lean in front of me. Credit cards in the stomachs. Getting the list in front of me. Legacy. Hey, what's up, you guys? Yeah, you know, I saw the movie Soul Food for the first time this last week.
All right.
That's a great movie, you know? Like, right away, the first 5 seconds, the song comes on about mama's love and how it's like the scars and shit. I was like, holy shit, man. I'm about to start crying. I don't know what the fucking movie's about. Yeah, but I didn't see the whole thing, you know, because I got drunk and shit. Yeah. But then the last part I remember seeing was when she was getting her foot cut off, you know, or she has getting her foot amputated. Yeah, and I was like, wait, I thought soul food was good for you. Like, never mind, we gotta go to Jack in the Box. Hey, you know the capital of South Korea? It's called Seoul. Yeah, so whenever I hear the word soul, I think you guys are talking about me and shit, you know? Yeah, like soul food, you know, it's food that was invented or is popular in Seoul, right? We got Seoul trains, you know? We got trains coming in through Seoul every day, right? The one thing South Koreans don't have is James Brown. No. He got soul and he's super bad. Yeah, you know, MC Hammer, he like gave away all his money, right? Yeah. You know, everyone's like taking advantage of him and stuff, and like, you know, it's kind of like a lesson to all of us, right? Can't be too nice, you know what I mean? Right away, you should have told all those people, like, hey, man, you can't touch these. Yeah, Shaquille O'Neal's like the happiest man on earth, right? He's always so jolly, right? I think because he's never been messed with. Like, how are you going to bully someone who's so tall his crotch is in your face, right? It's like, hey, Shaq, give me your lunch money. Never mind. Yeah, I did have sex with a black lady about a month ago.
Hey!
Happy Juneteenth! Once you go black, you never go back. But anyway, yeah, aside from her skin color, she wasn't any different than any other woman I've known with, you know? Except the only difference I could see is the whole time I was fucking, I was like, don't touch your hair, don't touch your hair.
That's smart.
Unless you're from the back.
You touch the eyebrows, though.
And one of my favorite movies, the Harlem Nights, right? Classic movie, right? You know, you had comedians from three different generations in that movie, right? Yeah, Red Fox, right? Best line of the movie is like, when it's swallowed, it, shut the fuck up. And you had Richard Pryor, right? He was Sugar Ray. That's the best, you know, name for a character, you know? Yeah. He's like, just shoot the dice and snap the tooth, motherfucker. And everybody was in that movie, right? Arsenio Hall, you know? What happened to that guy and shit? Did he die of, like, finger cancer or some shit? Ridley from A Different World was in there, you know, looking all fine as hell and shit. She's like half naked throughout the whole movie, you know. You know that's Eddie Murphy's idea and shit. It's like, hey, this scene, how about I fuck her and then I shoot her in the head, but it's her fault. You know, because you know Eddie Murphy's kind of cold like that, right? Yeah, just ask Scary Spice. Then you got Della Reese, you know, she has memorable performance, right? She's like, he shot my pinky toe. And at the end of the movie, the good guys win, you know? It's a fucking awesome movie, right? And it sparked, like, this worldwide interest for black women. Yeah, when she said that line, I got a girl whose pussy's so good, you throw in the air, it'll turn into sunshine, right? And then you see the girl, right? You're like, whoa, you know? And every man in America after seeing that movie was like, so Harlem's in New York. Well, I could be there by Wednesday. Yeah, I'm gonna go up there and give me some of that good old Harlem sunshine. You know, a couple weeks ago I was here and there was a white lady like sitting right over there, right? Give me the Jada Pinkett face. You know, you ever seen the Jada Pinkett face? And they're like, you know?
Yeah.
I'm like, what the hell, lady? Don't be sitting there giving me no Jada Pinkett face, you know? You better knock that shit off before I give the Will Smith hand.
Damn! Damn! That's crazy!
He was a rough one with that.
That's a good one. I like that.
I don't know what this last joke. You know, around Hollywood, there's all these billboards and this blind guy climbing Mount Everest.
What do you mean you're
a I was thinking, like, how did he know it was on top of Mount Everest, you know? Mm-hmm. For all he knows, he could have just been right over there at Mount Whitney or something. And then I was like, it's a pretty good business idea, right?
Go on,
taking blind mountain climbers up to the top of Mount Everest? Mm-hmm.
All right, my name is Owen. I'm out here. Thank you. Your pad, you got your card now. You got this black thing, man.
Oh, yeah, man, it was good.
Yeah,
she was like a little short petite, like
kind of
like a French lady.
Oh, yeah, got him some of that black coochie, y'all. Hey, we gotta give him his black card. He officially got the black card. Well, you always, you know, you part of Barbershop Comedy, so we got nothing but love for you, Iwanu. Give it up, y'all. Give it up again, y'all. Oh, yeah, that was super funny. Okay, man. But we about to really get stuff going on. Let me get this mic right. We got to sanitize after every other. And every other comic. You know what I mean? Because, hey, we got that thing coming back, they said. Oh, you heard right.
Why you look at that nigga?
I just said somebody we know. Was inflicted. All I'm gonna say. All right, we bringing in this next comic, bringing some beautiful female energy. Our OG sister, man, we love her much. Give it up for Donnie Keith, y'all.
Yourself. I see your nipples through that shirt. DJ Ethanol in here trying to entice fat bitches with nipples and shit. He like, I got on this silky shirt. I'ma kill these bitches with these nipples. You know, he be making this shit jiggle when he be mixing too, like, Happy Juneteenth, everybody. Happy Juneteenth, happy Juneteenth. Man, we was in here earlier before the show started talking about the astronaut bitch that drove all the way to Florida to kill her dude's girlfriend. But she had a diaper on. And somebody told me that when people go to the Times Squares at New Year's, that they be pissing and shitting on themselves, waiting for the ball to drop. So all of y'all that be in Times Square bragging, fuck y'all to death, you nasty niggas. Y'all adopted with baby diapers on, with adult dirty diapers on. And as a former bedwetter, I understand the discomfort in the situation. Because I was a bedwetter. And, you know, when you a bedwetter, when you preteen, it's embarrassing because you don't want to spend the night in anybody's house. You always praying, Lord, please don't let me piss. Because you know when you go to somebody's house, you're going to be dehydrated all night. You ain't going to want nothing to drink. Man, you're going to have sleep problems because you're trying not to go to sleep all the way because you don't want to piss on yourself. That's how my youth was spent. That's why bedwetters be nervous. Because they always trying to hide the shit constantly. Spend the night at your friend's house. She like, let's sleep sleeping bag. Let's sleep together. It's cold. No, bitch. It's going to be real cold around your waistline. By 2 in the morning, it's going to get warm, then cold. It's going to get real toasty. You're gonna feel like you're swimming down a strawberry river. You're gonna be swimming down the pissy strawberry river. Sleeping next to me. She's embarrassing too because I was thinking, damn, you know, parents gotta be a little easier on bad weather. They don't know the trauma them kids go through trying to hide that shit.